nothing like summer in the city. Someone under stress meets someone looking pretty. There's trouble in the air, you can smell it. And Alexander's by himself, I'll let him tell it.
I hadn't slept in a week, I was weak, I was awake. You've never seen a bastard orphan more in need of a break. Longing for Angelica, missing my wife. That's when Miss Maria Reynolds walked into my life. She said,
I know you are a man of honor. I'm so sorry to bother you at home, but I don't know where to go, and I came here all alone.
She said,
my husband's doing me wrong, beating me, cheating me, mistreating me. Suddenly he's up and gone. I don't have the means to go on.
So I offered her a loan, I offered to walk her home. She said,
you're too kind, sir.
I gave her 30 bucks that I had socked away. She lived a block away, she said,
this one's mine, sir.
Then I said, well, I should head back home. She turned red, she led me to a bed, let her legs spread and said,
stay.
Hey.
Hey.
That's when I began to pray, Lord, show me how to say no to this. I don't know how to say no to this. Oh my God, she looks so helpless. And her body's saying, hell yes. No, show me how to say no to this. I don't know how to say no to this. In my mind, I'm trying to go. Then her mouth is on mine and I don't say
no, no.
That was the last time. I said that last time, it became a pastime. A month into this endeavor, I received a letter from a Mr. James Reynolds. Even better, it said,
dear sir, I hope this letter finds you in good health and in a prosperous enough position to put wealth in the pockets of people like me, down on their luck. You see, that was my wife who you decided to
fuck.
Uh-oh, you made the wrong sucker a cuckold. So time to pay the piper for the pants you want buckle. And hey, you can keep seeing my whore wife if the price is right. If not, I'm telling your wife.
I hit the letter and I raced to a place. Screamed, I'll cut you in the face, she said,
no, sir.
Dressed, apologetic, a mess. She looked pathetic, she cried,
please don't go, sir.
So what's your full story, you said?
I don't know about any letters.
Stop crying, goddammit, get up.
I didn't know any better.
I am ruined.
Please don't leave me with
I am
helpless.
How could I do this?
Just give him what he wants and you can have me.
I don't want you.
Whatever
he
wants.
I don't want you.
If you pay, you can
body screaming, hell yes. No, show me how to say no to this. How can I say no to this? There is nowhere I can go.
Go, go, go.
When her body's on mine, I do not say
no.
Yes,
yes,
yes, yes,
yes,
yes, yes, yes, yes, yes, yes, yes, yes, yes, yes, yes, don't say no to this. There is nowhere I can go.
Go, go, go. So?
Nobody needs to know.
The Reynolds pamphlet. Have you read this?
Alexander Hamilton. At a torrid affair. He wrote it down right there.
Highlights.
The charge against me is a connection with one James Reynolds. For purposes of improper speculation, my real crime is an amorous connection with his wife. For a considerable time, with his knowing consent.
Damn.
I had frequent meetings with her, most of them in my own house.
At his own house.
At his own house.
Damn. Mrs. Hamilton, with our children being absent on a visit to her father.
No. Have you read this?
Well, he never gonna be president now.
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 That's one less thing to worry about. That's one less thing to worry about.
I came as soon as I heard.
Angelica.
All the way from London. Damn.
And
Angelica, thank God, someone who understands what I'm struggling here to do.
I'm not here for you. I know my sister like I know my own mind. You will never find anyone as trusting or as kind. I love my sister more than anything in this life. I will choose her happiness.